That's the Armalite AR-50. State of the art. Accurate to 2,400 meters. I've got the loophole Mark IV on it now, but I can always upgrade it to a Schmidt and Bender. Single shot, bolt, simple, effective, reliable. It fires the 50 caliber BMG. Very effective against soft targets in light cover, behind cars, small diameter trees and such. As always, I've gone to the trouble of grinding down the serial number.
Now, unless you ground a hole clean through, acid will recover it.
Well, that would be true, but I follow up with a pass through a random stipple machine press. Hides the patterns in the metal density. Should throw off your X-ray diffraction and some other higher-end methods. Nothing's perfect, of course, but this is close.
Looks like a hernia with a scope on it.
34 pounds, not including your bipod, which adds some heft.
Too much gun.
For most applications, I would tend to agree. SR-25 match rifle. Eugene Stoner designed semi-auto. That's about 11 pounds there. Not quite the range or the punch of the AR-50, but you're still talking about a 0.5 MOA at well past 1,000 meters.
I've heard they're prone to jam.
It's been known to happen in the field, but there's not a semi-auto built can boast it never jams. If that's a concern, you ought to stick to bolts. Good bolt-action rifle, if you jammed it, I'd wager you were setting out to do so. Which brings us to the M40. Tried and true, battle-tested. Essentially the same rifle used by Marine snipers since 1966. It's light, accurate, good for soft targets in the 8 to 1,200 meter range. You seem to know this one.
Oh, yeah. You could say that.
That's the A1 model. There's not much change from the original. Biggest difference is the stock. It's fiberglass instead of wood. It changed it over in 1970 or so.
Good. Wood warped like hell. You get it wet, you put it in the sun, gone. Somebody probably should have figured that out before they sent it into a damn jungle.
Yeah, probably. Well, if these aren't to your liking, I could get my hands on a few more.
No, I've changed my mind. Thank you. I don't need anything at this time. For your trouble?
Oh, it's no trouble. I make my living on repeat business. When you need what I'm offering, you know how to find me. Shot left, 1.5 minutes.
How many rounds have gone through the tube?
For a 7.62, you could put 3,500 through it and never know. It's about how tight she shoots. And this one's tight as they come. I'd say there's a breeze picking up downrange. Your barrel gonna be cold?
Let's suppose so.
Well, then you better have paid attention to that shot.
Yeah, I'd better have. Adjusting right, 1.5 minutes.
Send it. Hit. Sitter hit. I suggest you don't change up your ammo. Stick with the 168 grain boat tail hollow point. If it's an open shot, that is. If you got to shoot through a heavy window, I'll up you to a 180. But as you know, you'll have to recalculate the shot.
168 will do it.
How many boxes?
Just the one.
Ah, it's on the house. Now, one last thing. No offense.
None taken.
So? How's it look?
Meaning, do I see it?
Yes. Do you see it?
Basically, any lawman worth his salt's gonna spot that, yeah. Assuming that's a deal breaker?
Yes, it's a deal breaker.
Well, if stealth is what you're aspiring to, you'd best go with something more compact. 38 Special, Snub-Nosed. Got a concealed hammer so it doesn't catch on your belt when you draw. Tried and true. No nonsense about it.
Five shots?
Yeah.
Automatic has how many?
10 in the mag, 1 in the chamber. If you can't get it done with 5, then you're into spray and pray, in which case I wouldn't count on another 6 closing the deal. You'd load that with 158 grain hollow points instead of your standard wad cutters. It's got plenty of stopping power.
Can't get more dependable than a wheel gun. Right on with this.
That snubby will conceal up real nice if you carry it IWB.
A little harder to draw from, but it's really no substitute if you're intent on fooling a vigilant eye. Comes in polymer, too. I prefer the feel of leather. Old school, I guess.
Sure it's on the correct side?
If you're right-handed, it is.
I don't know. Are you sure?
Because maybe it'll feel better on the left side. A general rule, you don't want to cross-draw. Not unless you're going to be sitting. You know, store clerks, card gamers and such.
Either way, you're going to want to practice your draw. A lot.
Because if you're all fingers, well, it might could be him keeping the peace instead of you. Catch my drift?
What's this?
Well, that there is why you're going to pay me 5 times what you'd pay your neighborhood gun store.
Serial number has been filed off. So, to state the obvious, I don't want to be caught with this on me.
No, sir, to state the obvious, you don't. You know, mister, I've been providing my services for the past 30-odd years. You'd think in that time I'd learn better than ask a man his business, especially not one referred by the lawyer. But I do feel the urge to ask you, we strictly talking defense here?
Yes, absolutely. Defense. Why?
Because if it's just personal protection, aside from a bucket of money, you'd save yourself a potential felony 2 spot for carrying a weapon with a defaced serial number if you'd just buy it legally.
Yeah, but if you did have to use it, wouldn't it still be better to use one that couldn't be traced?
This is the West, boss. New Mexico's not a retreat jurisdiction. Man steps to you bent on doing you bodily harm, you got every right to plant your feet and shoot to kill. Some call it a moral right, and I do include myself within that class. All this to say, I'm happy to take your money. But if you're not a convicted felon,
you might best be advised to bear your arms within the confines of the law.
It's for defense. Defense.
I'll take it.
gets
the word, this won't wind up crossing the border.
It's never leaving town. Is there a manual, instruction manual?
I pulled some off the internet. It's in there.
Happy birthday, Mr. Lambert.